Sarah.
Hey.
How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
How was your walk?
It was amazing. Yeah. Tell you, come in.
It wasn't an option not to leave. And I think that if you look back and see the act of genocide that Saddam perpetrated against the Kurds, there were millions and millions of people who were killed. And it felt like an incredibly unsafe place, especially to raise a child. Actually, as a result of leaving, I missed a lot of the family connections that I would have had otherwise, and the relationships that actually would have been incredibly important to me growing up. I remember really lovely moments, and I remember really terrifying moments. For example, I remember in Russia, I remember feeling very cold and very afraid. We spent a night in prison. My memory is very different from my mother's memory. She remembers it being very harrowing. This is the funny thing about being a child, is I remember that the cheese was very bad. I remember they gave us breakfast. And I remember that the cheese that they gave us was the worst cheese I've ever had in my life. And that is my overriding memory of jail. I have a complex identity. I identify as British. More so than anything, I feel British. However, I also have a strong connection to Iraq and Kurdistan. And it's a connection that I've been trying to grow these past few years, especially because for a really long time, I didn't want to know about Iraq and Kurdistan. I think for a really long time, my journey felt like something that happened to me and not something that I owned. And I really wanted to own this story. And the only way I could think of owning it was to go back and redo it and to own the second journey. I decided to ask the internet, and the internet delivered. I posted a tweet just saying, "Hi internet, I know this is a long shot, but this man gave me a bike when I was five. He was working in a refugee camp in Zvola. My five-year-old heart exploded with joy. I just want to know his name. Help me." 6 hours later, we'd found him. I feel much more comfortable in my own identity and how I feel about it. I am British Kurdish, and that is how I identify, and I know what I went through and what my family went through to get us here, and I know what my life was like growing up here, and I know about my own history in a deeper way. I think wars have a devastating effect on people's lives immediately, but also for the next 10, 20, 30 years. And I think one of the reasons why I really wanted to find this man who had given me a bike is because his one act of kindness just reminded me that there is love and affection and compassion in the world.
I think think it's really cool that you tried to do the walk, because in some ways it's kind of what I tried to do. I tried to redo that experience in some way, or revive it, or get close to that experience. So congratulations to you for doing it, because that's the hardest bit. It was really great to see you.
Good to see you too.
Bye.